All right, we'll finish up with Ben Scott.
Hey Ben, how you doing?
How are you doing?
Good, thanks. I was wondering, I know Emory Jones obviously wasn't there for spring practice, but how much interaction did you have with him since he arrived on campus? And obviously the chemistry between center and quarterback is so crucial for the offense. Are you pleased with the rate of progress in that regard?
Oh yeah, like the chemistry is going a lot better than I anticipated, to be honest. We've been having like some walkthroughs going on, like player-led walkthroughs and stuff, and we've been getting the snaps down, and him and Paul and Trent are all still rotating still, and they're all asking me to go down and get some snaps in. I'm over there like, man, it's too much for me. But, you know, it's all good. You know, a while back, we all went to Topgolf, and it was fun just getting that chemistry going between all of us, and I think it'll be good going into the season.
With Joey Ramos coming in, how does that, do you think, does that move anybody around? Where do you think he might be able to play, help you guys? And what do you think it does for your depth?
Oh, that helps us a lot in depth, especially because Joey's a really versatile guy like myself, and he can play all three positions. So right now, like, we really have like 7-8 guys that could like start for us or rotate in. So our depth is really good right now at the O-line position. So we're just trying to see like where everyone fits in, you know, like I said, we got 7-8 guys to fill in those spots, and spring ball went good and we were looking solid. But now with Joey here, you know, you don't know what the line's going to look like, because you don't know if he's going to fit in there or if he's moving someone else around or how it's going to work.
So you think it's possible that he could get a look at center also in addition to you, which could possibly move you back to right tackle or no?
I doubt I'll be moving back to right tackle. I think center is the best position for me at the moment, and I think that will be the best for my future. And I think Joey right now, we'll be playing either guard or tackle, or Dez will play in guard or tackle, or Chris at guard and one of them at tackle. And, you know, LD and Emmett and Isaiah, they're all rotating, you know. Like, you never know what the lines look like, but we still have a lot of ball left before the season starts, so a lot of time to figure that out.
You look at the grasp of the offense on Glenn Thomas, you know, being a first-year offensive coordinator, do you feel that the comfort level is pretty strong from the beginning until the end of spring practice, or do you feel like it's still really work in progress going into fall camp?
I mean, we all are getting more and more into the playbook every day, and just like the little stuff, like we know what each and every play is, but like just that like little extra like angle you got to take on that certain play, or like if you see a certain formation or coverage, then like you got to call a different protection, you know what I mean? Like, especially as a center for myself, like a lot of different coverages, I'll have to change my call, and I need a lot of my fellow linemen to call out some other stuff that I may miss, like if they're in a certain coverage that I can't see the guys coming off the edge sometimes, like if the D tackle was like in my way and I'm already in my stance and stuff like that. So just the communication factor and all that stuff, just getting more comfortable in the playbook and, you know, like seeing how the plays build off each other will really help us out at, like, as we learn the playbook and really study into that more and more every day.
I don't know if shy is the right word, but you were a little bit softer spoken when you first got to ASU and trying to kind of find your role and all that. And can't really be like that when you're potentially the starting center and one of the more experienced guys. So what's that evolution been like for you, and how much are you focused on developing that further?
I mean, I don't really see myself as a soft spoken guy anymore, for sure. You know, like, I feel like our communication is really good on the O-line, especially like echoing calls and calling out where we got to go and all that stuff. And I think like, I'm still not going to be that guy that's like, rah, 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 motivate, like get on dudes for not going hard enough. And like, I'll motivate guys here and there. And I'll try to evolve my leadership skills into like becoming more of a vocal leader. But right now, there's so many guys that want to be vocal leaders and just want that attention and stuff like that. So I want to be more of like a visual leader, like seeing me like get that extra work in and telling guys like, oh, maybe like you guys want to go work out after this walkthrough or something and do that kind of stuff. But, you know, like I think just building connections with everyone and like everyone getting on the same page will really benefit us the most.
When it comes to the running backs group, obviously some new faces, some players that didn't get that much run last year are getting a lot more snaps on game day this season. Do you feel that there's any difference for you, you know, as an offensive lineman in terms of the blocking? And again, now you, on top of that, you got a brand new scheme. How do you feel the running game came out of spring practice?
Oh, I think our running game is phenomenal. I think we have four running backs that could rotate in throughout this season. We got X, Tevin, Daniel, and George, and maybe even more, you know, like, and blocking wise, I mean, we block it like we don't know who's back there because we really don't. Like, we don't know if they're rotating or not. And we're just trying to block it the best we can possibly do. And hopefully that if you have a lineman back there, he would hit the hole because it's wide open. You know what I mean? And I think we came out in spring running the ball really well. And our defense, they put up a good fight in the run game. You know, like they take pride in that run game. And we got some good plays on them, like almost every practice. So it was good to see and working like play action off of that and stuff like that. You know, it's always going to benefit the offense here and there. So that'll be good for us.
When you guys are losing three starters of the caliber that you lost, do you feel like you have a little something extra to prove, or what's the mentality of your group going in?
Oh, we definitely have a lot to prove, and it helps that we brought in a lot of guys from other schools. So they already have that mentality because they have to prove their and earn that spot pretty much. And the guys that are here, like myself, like we got to prove that this is still our spot. And I got to prove that I'm going to be the best center in the pack, which I really believe I will be. And I feel like our O-line mentality is to go out there and be the most dominant O-line. And that's something that you guys will see in this fall.
It's an entirely different thing playing center. What would you say are the biggest things that you're focused on making sure that you do a good job of there?
Oh, yeah, I've been training a lot. And it's a lot different than tackle. And especially during spring, like, I was really working on like the little techniques here and there and not building bad habits and all that stuff and getting my leverage right. And especially like playing out of a even stance, like getting out on like outside zone and sweep plays will benefit me the most where I can use my speed. Cause I feel like I'm a lot more athletic than majority of nose tackles in reality. So just a lot of that and like playing to my strengths, which gets overlooked a lot because a lot of guys want to do everything right, like textbook. But I think playing to my strengths will help me out a lot in the long run.
Do you watch a lot of Donovan stuff from last year or NFL guys or to as part of sort of assimilating to that role?
I don't really watch Donovan too much because he has a really distinct play style that not too many guys can replicate. And he also, yeah, he was really quick and liked to use his like quickness, which I will do from time to time, but he has a different play style for sure. But I like to watch Corey Lindsey, the Chargers center, and Ryan Jensen from the Buccaneers, and Creed Humphrey from the Chiefs. And I like to watch those guys just like looking at what their strengths are individually and trying to like see how my film compares to theirs in a way, like how they would treat certain fronts and certain looks and how like their steps are pretty much and just seeing how that works with them.
Just to circle back on Emery, how does he sort of shape the offense this year, on the field, off the field?
I mean, I haven't really seen too much, but he's for sure working at it. He already is learning the playbook and the walkthroughs, and you know, he's just getting better and better every day like everyone else. And you never know what might happen, but he's coming in here to prove that he'll be the starter. And you know, like, we didn't just bring him in here to be a backup. So, you know, we brought him in to compete for that starting position, and you know, he's working at it, and we're getting better and better every day. We already went out today and took some snaps and some throws with the receiver. So just getting that down and the playbook down and the chemistry with wide receivers and me, especially with the snap, because that starts it all, that'll be crucial for us.
What have you thought about his ability to sort of connect with the guys, relate to them, motivate, or any sort of those characteristics?
I mean, yeah, like he's a cool guy. Like he meshes with the team very well. And, you know, he's always here, like, motivating us. He always brings a positive attitude out here. And, you know, he's for sure leading the guys. Like when he asked us today, like, to go outside and go train a little bit more and, like, trying to get everyone, like, out there working, you know, like, that's a good quality to have, is that leadership role.
Thanks, Ben.
I appreciate it.
Thanks, Ben.